Yeah, let's do a reaction video. Do a reaction video. Yep. All right. Yeah. Yeah. Good channel. Watch the videos before. Yeah. Let's do it. All right. Went pretty good. Can't complain. Think it pretty. All right. Yeah. Let's just go and edit it now. Video came out well. No. Yeah. Definitely looks like shit.
Watch your profanity.
No! God! No! God, please, no! No! No!
It's a good way to spend an hour and a half, 2 hours. Ah, well. Do it again. Hey, what's good, everybody out there? Thanks for checking in again with Court Thoughts, the show where we basically talk basketball. I'm gonna keep it a buck with you. When I go through and make these videos, I don't, especially in this kind of idea that I've got where I wanted to do a reaction video, I don't want to watch the video beforehand, and I have previously tried to make this same video twice, different videos each time, and I just ran into problem after problem, and it was pretty brutal. But luckily, the channel that we're checking out today has a bunch of stuff on there. So the channel that we're checking out today is KingSwish on YouTube. I'll leave the link in the description. I definitely would suggest if you get a spare moment right after this to check it out. It's really good channel. I've actually seen and been following KingSwish for quite some time and checked out a bunch of their videos before. I really, really like it. They've actually got a real good like balance of like some real dope videos where it's like game winners or like ankle breaker move like moments or like all these like crazy like dunk moments or whatever, and then they've got these other moments like what we're going to be watching today. Now I would have to say one of the things that can be the most difficult part about navigating the game of basketball, outside of building your knowledge and obviously all your skill set, is sometimes you're not necessarily playing one opponent. Sometimes you could be playing two opponents, and that can be the referee. And that's not to like shit on referees, but the reality is that sometimes you might have a real poor attitude, or you rub the ref off the wrong way, or whatever. There could be a million different reasons why, but ref doesn't like her, and all of a sudden things don't get called, right? But then there's other times, and where things happen and you go, really? Like, how'd you miss that? Really? How'd you miss that? Today's episode, we're going to be doing a reaction video to KingSwish's channel. The video is called NBA Come On Ref Moments. I'll leave the link in the description for the video as well as the channel, so make sure you jump over there, give them a like and a subscribe, give them some love, and let's get into it.
Made him put the ball on the floor and give the ball up. And that's been a strength of Houston, having a big that can switch.
I mean, he baited him into that one.
Mm-hmm. Why,
first time I saw this, I was like blown away. at having the balls to do like a blatant travel.
That's a travel.
Good pull out from Ricky Rubio. Can you imagine if he just hammered it? Oh.
We know the results.
Pass deflected and stolen. Three on one for the Bucks. Holiday fouled by Booker. They didn't call it. Antetokounmpo banks it home. That would have been his sixth foul.
How do you not call that foul?
Now I'm real. I don't necessarily. I wouldn't say that I have like the finest understanding of when it comes to flagrant fouls. I know that there's like circumstances where it gets like if there's the last defender and you're defending them when they foul, like when you foul them really hard, there's different. It affects the like flagrancy of it or whatever. That's obviously a flagrant foul, right? Like it's without a doubt. But what's your understanding of the flagrant foul rule? Do you think that it needs to change? Do you think it gets abused too much? Jump in the comments. Let me know.
Pressure tries to turn the corner. Can't.
Oh, what is that? What is that?
Anything in a timeout.
Ooh.
I'd like to see that again. I got.
Think that. That is good, because he lost control of the ball. Technically, if you lose control of the ball, it's fine.
Steve Kerr talking to the team about pace. He said, this is the kind of game that's going to be tough, but he made a motion with his hand, like, keep going, keep cycling on the offense.
That's a bit hard to tell in the motion of the game.
You know what is so odd is Tyler Johnson got whacked there. Coming to this
game. Oh, geez. That's the other thing, too, because we've got the afterplay effects, too.
Oh, he missed it!
So whenever the ball passes through the cylinder, if it completely passes through the net or the cylinder, it's considered a bucket. So I don't know what happened there. If the ball stays within the net and then like exits out, that doesn't count. Somehow, like if it somehow went below the ring and then came back out, that doesn't matter. It has to go completely through the cylinder.
Clippers. Leonard drives, goes inside, lays it up, and an offensive challenge? Foul is called.
It'll be interesting to see what happens in the new season because of the fact that they've called out like baiting moves or whatever they've called it. I know it doesn't necessarily apply in that situation because Harden's trying to basically get a charge call, but I know that in offense, like, you know, you see people kick out their leg, like they do the Reggie Miller kick, and they like, you know, Trae Young's pretty bad with it as well, and obviously Harden's pretty bad for it, where they'll jump and they go like noodle legs, their legs stop working, and then they fall to the ground and they expect that the foul's going to get called. I know that they're going to be actively looking for that. I wonder how they're going to be doing it, because the game's obviously pretty fast pace, unless they're going to be relying on stop starting to try and work through it, which I think will kind of like ruin the momentum of the game a little bit, especially if you're in like an offensive flow, and then, you know, timeouts is a good defensive strategy to try and stop the offensive flow. Like, it's something that defenses can use to try and help break up their flow, but it'll be interesting.
Challenge.
But this is clearly a flop. He's not even in
James.
Front of him.
James going to the rim, kicks to the corner, Green a three to tie. He got
dirty
it.
Move.
We have
a lot of that happens
overtime.
Too. Sometimes you play against guys and they're holding shorts, or they'll like cup
down
your hips,
two.
Like they'll pull your
Miller
hips.
Splits the D,
I hate that shit.
Drives and looks like it should have been a goaltend. It should
that
have been a goaltend.
Be
no call.
Bruh.
Off the board.
That absolutely
that's
looked cool. Like it should have been a goaltend.
So as soon as it touches the board, it comes off. If you hit it before it hits the board, that's fine, but if it hits the board and comes off and then you hit it, that's golden, because it's a
second
line.
Took a shot to the face. Horford in transition, fouled by Corver.
That's fucked.
We showed you at the top of the telecom.
Man, he was heated. Oh, rightfully so, too.
I was going to say good defense, got a hand up, but drew the foul, and J.J. Redick has just been tossed.
Yeah, man, I don't know. Yeah, that's bullshit. That's an ego trip. That's an ego trip.
I think Josh interpreted that maybe showing him up.
You're playing, you're like your referee in your professional sports game.
Here's Butler with three. Butler with two. With one. Butler against Matthews gets it away. And no good. Do we have a foul? We do. A foul is called. And Jimmy Butler can win it at the line. Time's on the clock when the foul occurred here. Is it Giannis?
Where's the foul there?
Good strategy from Butler. I would have done the same. Got knocked to the especially court. About contact
Gallinari
on that last,
gets
like,
the
contact
inbound pass,
last
drives it. Tough mid-range, no good.
And he wasn't rewarded. It was an excellent screen. Collins was actually open.
What are you trying to do?
Durant makes a move, lost the ball.
Doesn't help that you're tiny. Oh, yeah. I remember this.
Outside Curry.
He was so far out, he needed a visa. He needed a travel visa. Look.
Absolutely, he's out. Wow.
Like 6 years out. Yeah, man.
And there is D'Angelo Russell. 23 years old. He was the second pick.
I'm surprised he didn't get tossed.
Rule number one. Don't bother. They get it wrong. Go back to them. Maybe say something to them after. Get your captain and coach
Beal,
to go back
great
to
great move. Just couldn't finish it. Bradley is 4 for 13 from the field.
Is
this
even the end? Is this even in the back?
Bounds, no call.
Let's go back and check it out. Look, check my man in the back. Check this out. Look at him. Ready?
Great move. Just couldn't finish it.
In my back.
Bradley is 4 for 13 from the field at the other end. Of knocked out of bounds.
That's his fault.
No call.
Now look at the way John attacks this. I mean,
I know for sure, like, I've gotten upset where, like, you get fouled real hard. Sometimes you get fouled real hard because you know, feel like you're just getting banged up all the time and nothing's happening.
In fouling, and they had Saric who had caught it. Now that might have been off of paint. I'm surprised they're not looking at that.
And that's what the Clipper bench is trying to make them aware of, and they don't.
Picked up by Williams.
That's hard to call.
And he threw the foul.
With the slow motion.
And Lou Williams may have a pretty good argument there.
Yeah, you
so
never
this
see
this is what they're trying
get
to
too upset.
Fix.
So right here, he may have
stuff.
A gripe as we look
that.
At it. Oh. He's off ball.
Yeah, he didn't touch it.
He's right, though. Like, I don't blame him. The call was bullshit.
Got Gobert up in the air, didn't get the foul.
Oh
boy. He was looking.
I would have been more upset that I didn't get the open pass.
Got to stop the clock. Angles with the ball. Will somebody foul somebody? 8 seconds to go. They waited a long time.
I'm going to see it here right now. Watch this.
Oh, that's one of the ugliest sequences right in like a while. And that was old too.
Vandal trying to get free.
That
Vandal fakes. And the ball went up and down. A traveling violation call on Randall. He's saying
he was pleading the case. Burks nearly turned
see,
it over.
See, this is
the,
another
There's
example.
Julius
like
goes
he
off his feet.
Still has control of the ball. I mean, that's on, where it's a travel.
Yeah, Randall
like,
went
if
over
you, I feel like if you had dropped it, I wouldn't have dropped it.
And in a combo.
If you drop
Checked
it, then
Houston. He'll drive. He scores.
You got a better chance.
How can this they not replay the game? He stepped out of bounds.
Obviously, some of these are a little bit older.
As a two-point victory for Milwaukee.
Right on the line, my guy.
This is just awful.
He puts like right in the middle from that angle. How far over is he?
What?
Yeah, he's in
bro, what are you talking about, man?
Clearly, he stepped out of bounds.
No, they not.
See, they miss it sometimes.
Woo, LeBron wanted that call.
Ooh. He got, oh, he threw him out. He threw him out. Oh, yes. Threw him out. Whoa.
He had Kyrie, too.
Irving on Sexton. We have an offensive foul caught on Irving. On a similar play in the first quarter, he pleads his case, as does James Harden.
Like, it's obviously a defensive strategy. It's obviously a defensive strategy to try and get the offensive player out of their rhythm, right? Or out of their their strength. And if they beat you and the foul gets called, I guess, like, defensively, you might think that you've won, but it's not going to last. Like, it's gonna get to a point where the ref's going to pick up on that tendency, and I think that it's going to work against your favor. So, you know, play defense. Like, play defense properly. Like, you know, I'm not necessarily the best defensive player, but in saying that, like, little shit like that will only get you so far. So, you know, either play better defense or get used to getting beat. That's how it's going to work.
Nice heads up. Oh,
oh boy. Oh, come on. No, no. Oh, Clarkson's upset.
Fucking get that.
And they're going to tee him up that quick.
Knicks are going to make you work. And that's defensively, they've been very good. That's a nice steal by Nerlens Noel. You've got another technical foul. If it's on Draymond, he's ejected. He's out. Wow. Draymond is ejected from the game.
You got to remember, Atlanta played in the same game. Oh, that's
Trae Young, and he knocked that down.
He shot that from Rockford. He says something to Chris Dunn.
Puts his hands on his hips.
He might be ejected. That's two technicals?
Yeah. Yeah, and he's been tossed out.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
Wow. He gave him, that's his second technical.
They have left. Good setup. Anthony. He thinks he's getting bumped underneath, and I don't disagree with him. They're coming under,
somebody's
him,
and
he's
got to
watch it. He's got to watch it because they need
to. I get that they're
the
like
floor,
defining moments, but like,
healthy,
54 pretty early in the game too.
Butler sets it up. Towns met up top, but he's going to the free throw line, and AD's going to watch it, and he just is out of the game. Unbelievable.
So it's like in the second quarter, you're 4 minutes like. You got 4 minutes left and you're getting more heated. And at the time, you're like
boy,
the centerpiece around your team. You know?
Harris,
that would be
again
a win defensively if it was me. Someone getting out like that.
Put it back, falls hard to the wood,
see, that's noodle legs. I love his face.
We believe in overtime.
He has not stopped talking yet. He did not like that no call down at the other end. I thought it was excellent.
He's hated.
Pella sets a pick and goes away. And it hits the referee, the ball, who was standing right in front of Gordon. Nice. How are you going to pass it to Gordon if the referee's guarding it? That's the best defense I've seen by a referee this season.
I think that they should, I don't know if they're necessarily rule, because I can't say that I've been in that situation too much, but there has to be some sort of a rule that if it hits the ref before going out, then the ball must be turned back if it's an attacking accident.
Timeout, and Michael Carter-Williams is running to the refs to show them his face as he bleeds profusely.
Points off the takeaway for Roby.
They may take a look at that one.
And he was trying to play the ball, right, but he may have gotten him above the shoulders.
God.
Let's see.
That's whoa! Good.
Man, and he's got a smile on his face. It's like, damn, man, that's pretty bad.
Points off the takeaway for Roby.
They may take a look at that one.
And he was trying to play the ball, right, but he may have gotten him above the shoulders. Let's see.
Like, oh, elbow? Whoa. Like the inside?
He said he's been ejected?
Yeah. That's wild. Yeah.
2 minute mark of our fourth quarter. Hornets are going to get to the 500 mark. He's got some affection for Dwight Howard. And he knew it was coming. Look at it. Yeah, it's coming.
I thought he would, like, presents his forehead.
You got that one right.
Yes, you may.
Loose. Gordon's got it. Hits the deck. And a timeout. Hornets get a timeout. Hornets have the basketball. Oh, did he give him the timeout?
Man, Green got a hella facial sometimes too, eh? Like the faces that he pulls when things are going his way.
Drives to the hole, makes a layup, but he thinks he's fouled. Watch his reaction here. Really frustrated, throws his
way to get the bucket.
Yeah, his mouthpiece at referee Scott Wall and is yelling.
Kind of like
he's
that.
Quickly ejected from the game, Kevin Durant.
And he's gotten heaps of like fines for that too. Man, great work. All right, guys, so that's going to do it for today's video. Thanks for checking in. I hope you enjoyed it. Please make sure you go over and check KingSwish's channel. It's a real testament to the quality of the videos that they produce over there. The other videos that I tried to do previously, so it was actually four videos that I tried to do reactions to, and just was too stupid to know what I was doing to not be able to get it done properly. But if you want to check out the videos, they were actually really good. It's kind of a bummer that I'm not going to do a reaction to them, because I feel like it's a bit fake. But the ones that I looked at were NBA That Was Savage compilation, NBA Suspend Him moments. The other was Slam Dunk Contest moments, and then obviously the one that we just watched now, which is NBA Come On Ref. Definitely go out, check out the videos that they make over there at KingSwish. Like I said, I'll put them in the description. Thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoy the video. Till next time, peace.